Hello friends, in this video we are going to see what's up using which database. So let's start. What's up users means there are out of 100, 80% people using the WhatsApp, right? Means over 100 billion messages are sent through the WhatsApp each day, means per day, and 42 million messages per hour. It contains different type of messages like the text, WhatsApp, means video, audio, images, Word file, PDF file, and all the things are secured in a secured manner. It means if you are sending hello world to the recipient, he will get hello world. But in between that, there is an encryption and decryption technology is used. Means that hello world is transferred into the ciphertext, and again, when we apply the decryption key, that ciphertext is come back to the, you know, original text, that is hello world. So let's see in detail. There is a data generated in WhatsApp in multiple formats, like the numeric data, text data, image, audio, video, PDF file, Word file, and you are calling on a WhatsApp audio call, video call. Then there is a status, means you are applying the status on WhatsApp, so it will be available for 24 hours. So such different things, like a different media we are using it, right? So that is structured data as well as unstructured data. Let's see in detail. Structured data, it means you are having some information like first name, middle name, last name, then there is a contact number, then whatever your contacts you have, then you are present in some groups, then there is a settings. So all this information is come into the structured category, and then there is a video, audio, all this data come into the unstructured category. And distributed system, it means one copy at multiple places. Suppose there is a primary server is down, at that time secondary server will up. Otherwise, means if we rely on only one server, then what happen? Then suppose there is a burden on one server, then obviously that server will get crashed, and second and we don't have any option, so there is a system downtime, correct? So at that time we are using the secondary server, means primary server, secondary server, and we are creating the multiple copies of the particular one message, so that what it does, it replicates the data over the system, and you can easily retrieve from them for disaster recovery point of view. Means there is a performance point of view as well. So there is a scalable as well. Means suppose you are choosing a one database, and which should be a scalable. And one more thing, storage. Obviously there are thousands of video and audio are available on the WhatsApp media, so obviously in the background storage is required. Means it's not a means a complete one data center, and there is a, and with having a lot of capacity, there is a performance and speed. Why performance and speed is come into the picture? Because let's say you are sending message to the recipient, at that time within a fraction of second he is receiving that database or a system should be a performant. So that's why these factors before selecting any database, means either it is in a structured way or unstructured way, we have to save the data, but we have to think different parameters of the system first, and then we have to consider which database is fit for us. So let's see which database using by WhatsApp. Obviously, there are two things. Means one is the sender and one is the receiver. One is sending the message and one is receiving the message. At that time, what it does? First of all, SQLite is the lightweight database which is using by the WhatsApp on their local device. Means suppose WhatsApp is the messenger application, correct? And they are using the SQLite is the database database engine. We can say it can store variety of data like the audio, video, image or text information, and there is a contact information as well. And it is widely used open source embedded database engine, provide lightweight disk-based database that does not require any separate server process. Means it is we can say standalone, and it is limited to the particular device only. Suppose there is a Oracle, MySQL, SQL Server. These are the relational database management system that require the client and server. But here, this is the only that particular device is inserting message or deleting message from that particular device, and that data is updated into the SQLite database. So, and second thing, when your message is conveyed from sender A to receiver B, at that time it comes through the WhatsApp server. So how it come? First of all, actually you are sending the hello message, and they are first of all it reached to the WhatsApp server, and then receiver B will get that message. This is the simple message, and which is they are following end-to-end encryption technique. And how? Because that SQLite database engine uses the 256 AES encrypted DB. Means your message is in the encrypted format. Hello is converted into the different ciphertext format with the help of encryption key, and that is routed through the WhatsApp network, and then at the receiver end he will receive that message in the hello world, means in the original format with the help of, at the end there is a decryption key is used, and he will get the exact the message, means plain text format. And one more thing, when there is a different message, like the when you upload the video in the WhatsApp, you have to send that particular audio message or video message to the recipient, then it will, with the help of the WhatsApp application, it uploads them on a cloud storage. Means what it does, first of all your that video will upload on the cloud storage, and that send it URL, means web URL we can say, to your contact or a recipient, and your recipient will download that particular message, means whatever that audio or video, and then the two ticks come at here, correct? And one more thing, you are having some information like the contact, setting, group information. This is in the structured format. So my WhatsApp using the MySQL for storing the relational data. And there is also one more thing, CDN, content delivery network. Means suppose there is a popular message, so they are routing through the content delivery network. And one more thing, Mnesia DB. So distributed database management system, and one copy at multiple places. So that is the role of Mnesia DB at here. I hope you understood this. and still you have any doubts, then please let me know in the comment section, and please give me a one like only. Thanks. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like it, share it, and please subscribe my channel. Thanks. Bye bye.